Hi everyone, it's a Wednesday afternoon, a little bit afternoon, and I thought I would do not a rainbow puzzle today. It's a little bit cozier, even though it's the first day of summer. I'm just feeling kind of cozy, so I thought actually that the first thing I would do is light a candle for my little aromatherapy. They call them like ceramic diffuser, I guess is what it is. And they even have some nails right now, so that's what it's sounding like. It's sort of a light green. And I thought I would light the candle. That goes underneath it. And the scent that I have today, I bought on my 40th birthday. It's by a company called Root and Shine. It's just a little tiny container. And it's a blend. And it's called Cozy. And it has, what does it have in it? It looks like it has pine scotch, sweet orange, cedar, fir, clove, and black pepper, and I quite like it. It's a little bit spicy and not too floral. I find I'm quite sensitive to lots of floral scents, so this one's quite nice. And so I'll just have that in the background. And today's puzzle, let's get started on that one. It's funny because as I'm doing this, I'm kind of squinting my eyes about the sun because it's quite high noon right now, and it doesn't really matter where I go on my desk, it's very bright, and I think it's funny that I'm doing something that's about being cozy. So let's do an arrange, and I made this one a little bit smaller. I find that when they're not rainbow, it takes me longer, so I did this one so that it has 40 less pieces. And it's just a picture that I found when I searched for cozy. I searched for hygge, H-Y-G-G-E, the Danish word hygge, and it came up with three pictures, and I wasn't really drawn to any of those, so I went with a close word. Oh, cozy. And I don't know if I should tell what the picture is. Of course, YouTube tends to have the little thumbnail picture, and that tends to be pretty clear. So I think this is a picture of a kitty, of course, and a candle. Which, if you've ever had cats near candles, they're very curious, and they can get themselves into a little bit of trouble. As did happen once to one of my favorite cats that I ever had, whose name was Jacob, and he was a lovely cat. I was very much his person in the family, and I would wake up in the morning and we would be holding hands. He would sleep up by my pillow, and I would wake up with his paw in my curled hand. He was very sweet. He was one of those orange tabbies, those boys that are very sweet, maybe not the brightest of all the kitties out there, but just a really big sweetheart. Loved him so much. He was a set of two that we had. Jacob and Isaac were their names. That's what we used the Bible for in my house. We use it to name pets. And So we had Jacob and Isaac. And Jacob's, he was so big. His shoulders were very wide. I used to say that he had big fat eyes. He had these big, beautiful eyes, and they were quite blue. And then Isaac was a little less orange, a little bit almost more gray, and his eyes were green. And he's very much my mom's person. I've never met a more quiet cat than Isaac. He was incredibly quiet. Oh, I think you go down there. You can sort of see where the, I think this is the wick. Oh, there we go. Is that actually the beginning of the flame? Perfect. We have some kitty whiskers. And anyway, I was talking about Jacob, and saying that he was a very sweet cat and very lovely and a little bit adventurous. He was a little bit out there, like, yeah, I'm gonna go do what I want to do. And he got too close to some candles, and of course, being Danish, during holidays, during Christmas, we always had candles going. So he got too close to some, and he burned his little whiskers a little bit, and even his eyebrows. You know how cats have this sort of whisker eyebrow hair. Pardon me. And he burnt that, and it was not completely, so that they curled. They did a little, like, they sort of got burnt a little bit and then curled up, and it was an amazing look. It was definitely a fashion statement that he was making. And I wish we had gotten pictures of it. We laughed at him for quite some time. Poor thing. So undignifying when you laugh at a cat. And you can sort of see this one's getting a little close. Let's do another arrange. Oh, there we go. Much clearer. Now it's all coming together. You go down there. Oh, maybe you go there. You go over there. I feel like I may be clicking on some pieces that don't make sense because I can't see them very well right now. I have very sensitive eyes to light, being blue-eyed, and so I'm finding I'm almost kind of squinting. I actually thought about maybe grabbing my sunglasses beforehand, but I thought it would be way too difficult to see. Oh, I think the sun just went behind a cloud. That helps me tremendously. Ah, there we go. I can see a bit better. And I think this kitty has a little bit of a smoosh face, which are always very sweet. Sometimes people say kitty baby has a bit of a smoosh face, and I don't see that. She doesn't have a long face. She's definitely not one of those long-faced cats. But I don't think she has a smushy face. And there's a piece that I think fits, and I feel really determined, and I just keep trying it. Like, somehow I'll convince it that it's supposed to go there. I don't know what I'm thinking when I do that. I'm very stubborn, I guess. I am a Taurus. They say we're supposed to be stubborn. Now there's these pieces. Oh, right, your kitty is what you are. You're not the candle. And what are you? I don't know what these pieces are yet. Hasn't become clear. You go there. You're part of the lid. Oh, this is coming together. When I do puzzles, I often think of the German phrase alles in Ordnung, which I may have mentioned before, I don't know. And it's just the soothing idea of everything in order. And it just sort of is, I find that soothing. Like, it doesn't feel like it's rushed. It's just like, yeah, just get everything in its place and it'll be fine. But I don't feel stressed about it. I don't think, oh, I have to do it all right now. It's just like, yep. Almost like everything in order and everything in its time. Which I find to be a helpful idea. I see that little kitty's face. So sweet. Where do you go? Oh, you go right there. Oh, and the sun is back out behind. It's peeked out from that cloud. You have kitty whiskers on you, I think. I sometimes feel like I'm spoiling myself by only doing rainbow puzzles because the colors are just so obvious. And there's just something very comforting. That to me feels like I can almost already see where the pieces go. The colors go in here. You look at the picture and you kind of can almost guess where they go. Really simply. Whereas ones without it, not so much. You have to look a bit more at the shape. Oh, I'm glad I didn't do any more pieces than this, because with the sun in my face, it's getting a bit tricky. Oh, you can see the kitty's coming very much into focus. Where do you go? Oh, you probably go down there. And you go up there. There we go. Right now I have all my doors open. And it's very warm out. And my cat kitty baby can sort of come and go as she pleases. She likes rolling around on the pathway, the cement path to our house. And I had the door open and I could hear my mail carrier come to the front door. And I had actually assumed kitty baby was out because I heard someone go, "Kitty." And I'd assumed they had run across her sitting out there, but lo and behold, I went outside and she was smushed up against the window in the office between the desk and the window, and really quite smushed. So I had to get a picture of her for that. I love how cats just get comfortable in so many little squishy places. Okay, so here we go, our last few pieces. And we're done. Oh, what a little sweetie. Watch your whiskers.